Welcome to the Flooded Member Detection System from Impact Subsea. Let's have a look inside the box and see what there is. The first thing we have is the cable reel, which can be provided in 100 and 200 meter lengths. Next, we have the Fmd Probe Holder. Then, this transit case. The transit case contains the Fmd Probe, the Fmd topside interface box, along with a USB cable and power supply. Retention screws for the Fmd Probe Holder. A subsea whip that's provided for ROV integration. A spares kit. A quick start guide, which details the pinouts of the Fmd Probe. And a USB memory stick, which contains the software and manuals. Let's see how all this is put together. There are a couple of additional tools you will require. These are a 3mm Allen key or hex driver, some connector grease, and a small piece of cloth or blue roll. The first step is to spool off a length of cable from the cable reel, but to do so we need to release the brake. On the side of the cable reel, there is a handle which is usually facing inwards to the main body. Simply locate the wing nut underneath the handle, unscrew it, turn the handle round, then re-tighten. This will give you access to the braking mechanism. Find the metal clip that's behind the handle and lift up to release the brake. You can then leave this clip to dangle by its retention cord. We can now unspool a small length of cable. Next, we take the Fmd Probe Holder and insert the cable through the smaller of the two holes. Before we connect the Fmd probe, however, we now need to wet the connector. Taking the tube of connector grease, pack the subsea end with grease. Next, we take the Fmd probe and, ensuring the correct orientation, push the two things together. This will force out some connector grease, so taking our cloth or blue roll, clean this up. We can now secure down the red locking sleeve, just so it's hand tight. The Fmd probe can now be slid back into the probe holder, taking care to ensure that the flats of both the probe and the probe holder line up. We now need to take one of the retention screws from the two provided and place it into the retention screw hole on the Fmd probe holder. This is then secured using our 3mm Allen key. Again, this just needs to be hand tight. The Fmd probe will be held nice and snugly within the probe holder. We now need to take off a length of the topside cable from the cable reel. The topside cable is located at the same side as the braking mechanism on the cable reel. simply unclip it from the metal clips that surround the rim of the cable reel until you have a length that you require. We can now take this cable and plug it into the FMD topside interface box. Remove the protected covers from the two ports. The topside cable from the cable reel plugs into port marked ISA500. Ensure that the orientation of the cable matches that of the port itself. There are some little key marks to make sure that this cannot be put in the wrong way around. Simply push the cable connector onto the port and rotate the locking sleeve to snap shut. Now we can take the power supply and place it onto the port marked power. As with the previous port, there's also some key marks to make sure it cannot be fitted around the wrong way. So push fit it together and rotate the locking sleeve until it snaps shut as well. Finally, we can now take the USB cable and plug this into the FMD topside interface box. Using the squarer of the two USB connectors, plug it into the port marked USB and make sure it is secure. This completes the system assembly, and we're now ready to install the software and fire the system up. For more information, please visit our website or our social media pages. Thank you very much for watching, and we hope to see you again.